Welcome back. Take another look at big time. We were talking about holding that cell, the blender we got somewhere around just below 15 for 2000 for one buy, 1500 for another. And that was set to sell at 25. And I got a little greedy, decided I wanted to get 100% gains. There was a couple spots where I thought it was going to hit. We'll take a look at that. And instead of taking partials like I should have and just re-entering, getting my little soldiers back, I could have made a lot more. So we're gonna take a look at this. So on the daily, bought about a month ago, a little over a month ago in October, made some videos. We bought right in here on the pullback from this high. Would have been nice to get the fill down in there, but we hadn't added more money yet. When I saw this, I really thought I was gonna get the rest of that push. So I was like, yeah, I'm gonna set, you know, 25 something and 34 to the top of the range. And right now it's probably going to expand up to there, but had I just sold at the 20 cent mark and pulled back and reloaded, I could have made way more than I'm going to make. So right now I'm about to make 75 to 80% on this. I'm trying to decide if I'm going to get out right now and try to reload or just do this. I'm going to drop to the time frames. And in fact, I'm going to look on another, I'm going to take a look over here. So just about the sell set right now, I have 15,000 set to sell at 25,770. And 10,006 the rest of that secondary buy at 34. So like I said, I've got a blended of about just under 30. If I wait for the 30 sell, I will get 100% gains. Actually, I don't want to do that though, because I could have reloaded several occasions and traded that. I position traded this and I momentum traded and day traded the rest for some other buys and sells down here. So what I'm looking at now is, do I want to try to reload and even get a few more cents? Because a few cents is a lot of money. So let's drop time frames. See, if I just leave it alone right now, it's probably going to push over all on its own. It's probably going to go ahead and fill that first one. Maybe I don't get greedy and pull that down to sell both, get all my money back. That'll give me about $6,500 return total on the $3,500 invested. So I got a 6 hour. See, it's getting a little weak. Let's decide here. Let's look at a 4 hour chart. See, it's had some pullbacks. Go ahead and look at how the 1 hours are forming. Are we losing momentum? Potentially, but it's holding itself up. Like, it's probably going to press over on its own. Just keep dropping time frames. I've got another buy set here with, I don't know, like $3,000, some other momentum trading. I was making it 20, and I'll adjust it as needed because that's not a position. That's for momentum. Okay, so right now, we hit a high of 25,382. I had a sell set of 25,770. Had I had that set at 25 like I wanted, it would just already be out. Look at the 5 minute pullback. On the 1 minute chart, do I really need to pull this right now and sell and try to reload, or should I let it press over? I've made the mistake several times of trying to get a little more out of it and it stalling here and there. It is above every high from before except for the actual initial launch high, which I do believe is going to go over. There's a lot of stuff running 100%. And I think I just want to get all my money back right now, reload, and then probably put in like a 23 buy. I'm probably not going to get greedy. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's just go ahead and cancel those orders. And the other one I have set up here for this particular entry right here, I have a buy set for $3,191, basically 3,200, but it pulls a little bit because of the cost. And then I have a sell set for 39 cents and 35 cents for the take profit. It'll probably hit the 35s, but again, that's just something I had set while I'm asleep in case it fills. And if I wake up and it's at 22 cents, you know, I've got 10% gains, I'll sell it. If it ramps on its own and hits the trigger condition, so be it as well. This looks like it's going to pull back, so I'm going to stop yapping real quick and let's go ahead. Because while the daily candles look great, and I'm sure they're going to expand, I don't want to leave too much on the table. So let's go ahead and there we go. So let's go ahead and cancel 34 sell. Let's cancel that. All right, trying to cancel both those. So we're just going to go ahead. We have 25,638 big time to sell. We have $11.53 in the account. So let's just go ahead here and drop into the 1 minute. And we'll probably just sell. Yeah, we'll probably just sell market. Or you know what? We could sell limit just a little bit higher, right? Why not? 24747 max big time. That'll give us 6328. Let's just go ahead and do that. All right, so our order filled. So we have our money back, $6,346 off a $3,500 investment. That's after fees minus that $11. So let's just call it what? Let's just call it $6,330 minus $3,500 we had into it. So $2,830 gains divided by $3,500. So we made 80% on our money. In about a month. That's not too bad. So we're going to take this and reload it right now in a minute once I look at the charts a little more. Thanks for watching. Good luck in your investing. Welcome back. Take another look at Big Time. We were talking about holding that sell, the blended we got somewhere around just below 15 for 2000.
Welcome to Cashflow Chronicles, Unlocking Financial Freedom. This is going to be a digital...